At least 142 people were killed in different violence attacks in the northern part of Nigeria last week, from July the 18th to 24th. Also, about 44 others were also kidnapped in the region amidst the rising insecurity across the country. According to a security report by the Council on Foreign Relations, Kaduna State recorded the highest number of cases, with 6 incidents of killing and kidnapping, while Katsina State had 4 incidents. The Council of Foreign Relations, an American think tank, said it tracks insecurity across Nigeria using information from newspapers and families of victims of various violent attacks. Joining us live to understand all that is going on is from Kaduna is Yerima Shetima, who's the president of Arewa Youth Consultative Forum. Good to have you, Mr. Shetima.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Thank you for joining us. I'm sure you're following up all the incidents, the matter of killing that's been going on. What's your reaction to this age-long ethnic crisis, if we put it that way?
Well, it is sad and very unfortunate that such things are going on, and over we lost people on daily basics, and those people are Nigerians. And every normal person should get worried about the situation, because to be an injury to one must be seen to be injury for all. We are more worried about the situation and we're concerned about it. But unfortunately, the government is not doing enough to address the situation.
Mm-hmm. I mean, there's been reports from different quarters, you know, fingering the Fulani as perpetrators of this crime. I mean, tell us what you know as Arewa youth leader in this matter.
The fact of the matter is that I get worried and my heart bleeds sometimes when issues of importance come to play or come to the fore, and people begin to narrate it and make it attach certain sentiments to it. Fulani don't know Fulani, Hausa or no Hausa, tribes or no tribe. The fact of the matter, a crime has been committed. And let us look at it as a crime. Those bandits are crime. There's no crime that is linked to any particular ethnic nationality that other ethnic nationality does not commit. The fact of the matter is that a crime is on, and we must be serious and more decisively about it. But by the time you begin to narrow it to issue of ethnicity, somebody is being killed and you link it up, somebody still good, you link it to a particular tribe, I don't think we are really doing good for the country. So the fact of the matter is that certain crimes are on from both sides, both the Fulani side and even those so-called indigenous of a particular place. Mm-hmm. And we must be seen to deal decisively, because at some point, some group will attack this group. The next moment, there will be a reprisal attack on these other groups. And this must be stopped. Right. But by the time we begin to narrow it, whether it's Fulani or no Fulani, for God's sake, we won't get headway. This is not about Fulani or any other tribe. It's about criminals. A bandit is operating. Let us deal with them decisively. Nobody's above the law, wherever it comes from. So, but by the time we narrow the whole scopes to issue of ethnicity and whatever, I can assure you we won't get it right. Mm-hmm. This is a crime being committed by a criminal-minded people from both sides, and they must be dealt with. Mm-hmm. So no excuse, no law says whoever commits a crime because it's come from a particular tribe, it must not be dealt with. The crimes are crimes, and they must be dealt with decisively. The government must be upbeat. Beyond these rhetorics, stories, politics, and so on and so forth, we must be seen to be very objective, for God's sake. Those lives are lives. Wherever the lives come from, at some point, they are human. And we must be seen to do it right and do it and get it directly and address the issue once and for all. We are tired of this killing on daily basis.
Mr. Shetima, there are also conversation indicating that, you know, the government, both at federal and state level, is not proactive enough to save, you know, the lives of people and property, as you have also explained, which is what matters here. What's your thought on that?
Exactly what I have a thought about, because the fact of the matter is that on daily basis, there are problems in all over the country, but the northern side of the country take the major part of these problems. The government has failed woefully when it comes to the issue of insecurity. On daily basis, people don't sleep with their two eyes in the northern part of the country. We only got to hear about the Southern Kaduna case. There are other places, Katsina, Zamfara, and other places. Everywhere there's a problem. Sokoto, there's a problem. In fact, entire northern state now, there's nowhere you have peace anymore. There's problems, and the Nigerian at large is also sick. So let the security agency work. But I also know that this issue of security must be seen to be all-inclusive. All-inclusive in the sense that as long as these military are also determined, and I hope they are determined anyway, we must be seen to bring all hands to be on decks. The communities must have to cooperate. They have to work beyond just looking at the whole thing is just an issue of just the security agencies doing it. They have to work, and also the government must be determined decisively without any politics, without any considerations. They must be dealt with as criminals, common criminals.
I mean, it is very worrying to hear you, even as you said it, that there's no, you know, there's no peace anywhere. That's very, very worrisome to hear. Looking at solution, what do you think should be the lasting solution to this crisis? If there would ever be a lasting solution, what would it be?
Because I am somebody who is almost always optimistic that whatever, no matter how dark it is, there will be light at the end of the day. And whatever have a beginning, have an ending. So I just hope, and I just hope they are determined, the government of the day, to address issues decisively once and for all. Issues must be brought to the fore. People must look to themselves face to face to address the issue. Where somebody is found wanting, nobody is above the law. If there's somebody engineering or sponsoring this conflict, must also be brought to book and be dealt with decisively and be prosecuted and convicted. But by the time we begin to look at it, that some people are above the law, you cannot bring them to the fore and ask them certain questions, then we are making a mistake. And this will continue. So for me, I strongly believe that we will get out of this mess. But my worry is that for how long will it take? Because on a daily basis, per hour, people died. So we have to arrest the situation before almost everybody seems to this mess up. Now, at the end of the solution comes, then it becomes a dead cry after the burial or whatever. I hope it won't be too late. Let us do it right. The government can be. There's no institution that is more stronger than government institutions. And if the government are determined, they can address this issue once and for all. Let us do it right and get it right. Mm-hmm. Because this problem that today is happening in Southern Kaduna could have as well happened anywhere. So if the government cannot do it right and people continue to go like this, they automatically, one day will just run into anarchy. The way it is, and you underestimated, you think it's a joke, it will just flame up everywhere. And when one will be flame up everywhere, considering the fact that we have a lot of challenges at hand today, then we'll end up running into a big mess. And the country at large will be in a serious dilemma. And I hope we don't get to that point. Government must stand firm and address issues once and for all. Those who are saddled with responsibility cannot do it right, For God's sake, put them aside. Let them step aside. Bring in people with more ideas that can address the issue. Over and over, we keep talking one thing. It keeps happening.
Alhaji Yerima Shetima, President of the Arewa Youth Consultative Forum, we must say thank you so very much for your time and do keep safe out there.